Robertson fades. Beautiful. Beautiful. It's beautiful.
He makes amazing tracks. He has a great gift for visualizing sounds, if you know what I mean.
He's got a good understanding of the instruments. Like I say, you know, when you sit and play something, he's got a good angle on it.
Even after being around for a long time, I learned a lot from Martin, and especially in the studio. He's a workhorse, and I have a tremendous amount of respect for him. What are these hands for?
Well, the story behind the album really is I wanted to do a solo album for a very, very long time, and I've been known for writing songs for other acts. I've been lucky enough to have some success that way, but I've always wanted to do my own record.
The first two things that we wrote were both covered within a fairly short space of time, one being We Built This City and the other one was These Dreams. Both of those went to number one, which was like really quite an achievement, and something that obviously encouraged us to work together some more. Put on your red dress, baby,
wear your smile. I put a studio in the garage and stayed away from everybody for 2 years and worked on, stopped collaborating with other people and worked on the record. Tried to make something very honest and very true.
I wanted it to be human, I wanted it to be honest, and my favourite recordings from the past have always been records that I felt like I was almost in the room with the artist as he did it. To me, it's like a very rich tapestry of deep colours. To sum the record up, I'd have to say it's a very, very honest record and shows a lot of the influences of what I grew up loving. 'Cause I'm gonna be the keeper of the flame. I always loved American music. I've been a record fan. I bought a lot of R&B, so I loved the Brothers Johnson, Graham Central Station, Quincy Jones, all the Motown stuff.
When I started off writing songs, I had my own band, and we were called Q-Phil.
The first song was called Doctor on the Radio. What a fantastic title. And we sold about 5 copies in France. We made another record straight after that called Dancing in Heaven, which became a hit in America. K-Rock played the hell out of that record, so it started us off in L.A. In my room, I can
hear her fight his kiss. The greatest thing really was the people I had on the record were my dream players. Working with Phil Collins on drums was a great thrill because I believe him to be one of the greatest drummers of our time.
The more we experimented, the more it really turned into just a lot of fun in music and sounds.
By working with people like Robbie and working with people like the Blue Nile, I really wanted to get out something which was deep inside of me. And the violins are playing now, but I really felt like a lot of the songs that I'd written for other people didn't really totally reflect what I was about.
I think it's something he felt he had to do because, you know, it was in his soul. I suppose when you write songs for other people, you're giving your babies away. So I think he wanted to, you know, it's kind of obvious, wanted to do his something for himself. Oh, why can't we
shake the invisible? My favourite song is Shape the Invisible, purely because of what the lyrics say. I was reading a book about Leonardo da Vinci, and he mentioned this Shape the Invisible in a sentence, and I thought, what a great title. And at the time I wrote the song, there was, as there always is, trouble in the world, and I really wrote it as a wish song. There's a light in your heart. There's a shadow in the shade of your eyes. There's a song called A Light in Your Heart, which I wrote with Bernie Taupin, and this song's been around for quite a while.
Light in My Heart's a very simple song. I mean, it's a very direct, emotional piece of work.
I feel very strong about Light in Your Heart, that it's one of Bernie's best lyrics. You must know I was made for you. Yeah. And there's another song called I Was Made For You, and that song has a very distinctive kind of Gaelic feel to it.
He's looking for a similar thing in his music that we're looking to. I'm not saying the music's all the same, but we're both looking for emotion. So put on your
let me see you smile. The song Put On Your Red Dress, it's a romantic song about basically saying we've been up through some ups and downs, but I'm going to come to your house, knock on the door, we're going to go walking down to the docks, and we're going to forget about our problems.
The House of Stone and Light became really a song of going, looking for the stillness within yourself. And after I knew that, the words wrote themselves.
I think it's a terrific song, and I really enjoyed playing on it. I wanted to play on more of the album, but I'm sure that we'll do plenty in the future.
I think that the album's going to surprise a lot of people because it's not really, it's a different style to what a lot of people have known me writing for other people.
They're very melodic songs, simple, but with deep-seated roots, which evokes both personal and universal emotions.
Knowing that you get that tingle down your neck, that you've hit a couple of melodies which are very special and they're going to last, that's the big buzz.
For me anyway, the fact that he's done it makes us. That's the success.
There's no rest. I mean, when I work with him, I mean, he worked me into the ground. He's a wonderful character, and I think he's going to make for some interesting theories in this business when he pops out of his box.
I really wanted to make a record that you would want to play 2 years from now, 3 years from now, and that has always been my goal, really, to make something that would last, something that would transcend style, fashion, or image. It would just be strong for its passions. To find my soul, yeah. I must go there to find my soul, yeah.